Well, some state lawmakers believe that the law discriminates and say testing should be based on functional and medical fitness rather than age. But while that's still being discussed, those who do test the seniors say it seems to be working pretty well.
A few weeks shy of 88, and Glenn Leach is at the wheel.
Still going along. I don't go too much, but 5 or 6 thousand a year.
But he's not willing to give that up. So Wednesday, he visited the DMV for his required road test, something he's had to do every 5 years since his 75th birthday. It's the law in New Hampshire.
We do feel it's a necessity, and it's proven to be effective.
900 people 75 or older fail the test each year, but that's a fraction of the more than 9,000 who take it. Jeff Oberdank says taking a license away is the toughest part of the job, but
as far as public safety is concerned, it's a tough decision, but it's the only decision.
Seniors first get their eyes checked.
Perfect. All right, you want to head right back around? Very well.
And then they pull their car into a spot and wait for the licensing officer.
We put them through every element, through the city. We take them, you know, anywhere that they would normally drive or you and I would normally drive.
We followed as Glenn maneuvered through Manchester, stopping at lights and negotiating intersections.
We're looking for slowed reaction time, mobility issues, making sure that they're looking in the right directions and that they're able to move their head.
They get three chances, but for Glenn,
I passed, I guess. Got a license.
Were you worried at all? Were you nervous?
Hey, who wasn't? Especially when you get to be an old buck.
But he figures if the professionals say he's okay to drive, he's good to go.
The only one to find fault with my driver is my wife.
Now, there's also debate about whether younger or older drivers may pose more of a threat on the roads. Now, the state's Department of Safety has some data, and it shows that so far in 2009, there have been 3 fatal crashes involving people 71 and older. But as for 16 and 17-year-olds, the newest drivers on the road, there were 4 fatalities since the year began. Reporting live, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.